Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam and this video is about patellar tendon ultrasound. We will compare the normal ultrasound image of the patellar tendon of the knee with patellar tendon pathologies, mainly including patellar tendinopathy, which is also known as jumper's knee. It is an overuse injury of the knee and it usually occurs in sports players. This is a normal image of the patellar tendon. This fibrillar structure is the patellar tendon. Overall, this structure is hyperechoic and has a fibrillar pattern with alternating hypoechoic and hyperechoic lines. It has a smooth echo texture. This hyperechoic structure is the patella, the kneecap, with posterior shadowing because it is a bone. And over here, this is the tibia, the tibial tuberosity, where the patellar tendon attaches to the tibia. This area is the Hoffa's fat pad. It is located posterior to the patellar tendon. Mainly, it is a hypoechoic structure. This image is in a longitudinal plane. And over here, we have an image of patellar tendinopathy. The normal AP thickness of the patellar tendon is approximately less than 3.5 millimeters, but this can vary amongst different individuals. In tendinopathy, the thickness of the tendon will increase. You can see an increased thickness of the tendon and it will be filled with hypoechoic areas, these dark areas within the tendon. Normally, the tendon is hyperechoic, it is a bright structure, but over here we have some dark areas. This indicates degeneration of the tendon, and some areas will have tears as well. The tears will appear more hypoechoic or basically anechoic. The Hoffa's fat pad can appear hyperechoic in some cases due to inflammation. You can see this area is hyperechoic as compared to the Hoffa's fat pad in the normal image. Here is another image of tendinopathy. The tendon is thickened. This is the affected area. It has hypoechoic areas as well as a small disruption. This anechoic area represents a tear and there is edema and fluid collection which makes this affected area hypoechoic. This fluid filled structure is the infrapatellar bursa. The normal bursa is hard to see on ultrasound. Usually it is invisible. But in this case, there is inflammation, so there is fluid accumulation in the bursa as well. This is another case of patellar tendinopathy. The thickened tendon is filled with hypoechoic areas. A tear is present here, this disruption. Also, there is fibrosis, which means it is a chronic case of tendinopathy. In chronic cases of patellar tendinopathy, calcifications will be found. These are the calcifications. The tendon is thickened and the hypoechoic areas are present as well. This has occurred at the proximal aspect of the tendon where it attaches to the patella. This is a transverse image showing the patellar tendon. This is the patellar tendon. And over here is an image of tendinopathy with a thickened patellar tendon, which is filled with hypoechoic areas, and it even has calcifications. Here is another transverse image of patellar tendinopathy. We can see a very thickened tendon, and it is filled with hypoechoic areas, as well as an anechoic area representing a tear over here. On color Doppler, increased Doppler signals will be found within the tendon in case of patellar tendinopathy. This indicates increased vascularity due to inflammation. The tendon is thickened and has tears and hypoechoic areas. The Hoffa's fat pad is significantly hyperechoic, and there is a significant amount of fluid accumulation in the infrapatellar bursa. This is another image of patellar tendinopathy showing hypoechoic areas at the proximal aspect of the tendon, and it is thickened as well. And when color Doppler is applied, we will see increased vascularity in the affected site. Normally, no significant Doppler signals are found within the tendon, but in case of tendinopathy due to inflammation, increased vascularity is seen. This is another chronic case of tendinopathy. It has a calcification over here. Another feature that may be seen in chronic cases is the changes in the patellar bone where the tendon attaches to the patella. You can see the bone surface is rough and irregular, whereas in the normal image, the surface of the patella is smooth. In this image, we can see a partial patellar tendon tear at this location. You can see this disruption in the normal fibrillar pattern. This is a partial tear. And here we have a complete patellar tendon tear. There is a full thickness disruption of the normal fibrillar pattern over here. This is the tear. It involves the entire thickness of the tendon. The involvement of the entire thickness indicates a complete patellar tendon tear. This is the rupture, and it is surrounded by hematoma. These heterogeneous areas are the hematomas. The tendon is thickened as well. Here is another image of a complete tendon tear. Here is the full thickness disruption, the rupture site, and it is surrounded by heterogeneous areas, the blood collection or hematoma. This full thickness disruption indicates a complete patellar tendon tear. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.